Wow. This is a super fun song. There's so much that's so musical about it. And I kind of know Edgar Winter. I did a record with Edgar that just came out called Brother Johnny. And we did some of it here. It's got some great guitar players on it. I did rhythm parts, but some of the actual kind of famous guitar players were Joe Bonamassa, Kenny Wayne Shepherd, Billy Gibbons, David Grissom, Steve Lukather, Doyle Bramall, Taylor Hawkins sang on it. Warren Haynes, and then one of the songs I did, Michael McDonald sang, Joe Walsh played on it, Ringo Starr played on it, so it was pretty cool. And I want to show you guys something. This was really unexpected. I have this old out-of-tune spinet piano in our living room, and when we took a break from one of the sessions with Edgar, he went downstairs and he did a little playing on our piano in our living room. It was kind of, if you would have told me when I was 15 or 16 years old that this was going to happen in my life, I would have probably fainted. But let's just roll this little iPhone film. So I found out from Edgar that the guitar player on this song, on Frankenstein, is Ronnie Montrose. Now, Rick Derringer produced this album, and often when a guitarist producer makes a record with an artist, they secretly play some guitars. So I was very, very curious. And I have a friend named Colin Hay from Men at Work, and he's actually in Ringo Starr's band right now with Edgar. And the other day I said, Colin, can you ask Edgar who really played on Frankenstein? And he confirmed that it was Ronnie Montrose. And what I didn't realize about Ronnie Montrose is he is an amazing rhythm player. I'm going to take you to this section where he just kind of is comping rhythm during the synthesizer solo. This is his isolated guitar from the record. It's such a good feel. And I always thought of Ronnie Montrose as kind of a heavy rock guy. But I understand why he was in the band. I mean, it's a great feel. And then you go back to these parts, and there's some sort of fuzz on the guitar, I think. It's kind of typical of instrumentals like this. This song went to number one in 1973, but kind of only by accident. It was on the B-side of a single called Just Hanging Around, I think. And somehow, you know, the B-side got played by a DJ, and he loved it. And then people started calling into the radio station saying, play that again, play that again. One more reminder, there's a sale on the Masterclass. Click the link below. There's a 14-day free trial, so I did that on purpose so that you can take your time with it, and if it's not right, you just opt out. But check out the sale if you want. Cool. Oh, you saw them on the same tour. You know, I saw them too. I saw them on this tour, and they were so great. And I'm going to ask you, Mark, do you remember when Dan Hartman, the bass player, in the middle of this concert, Dan Hartman took a white Stratocaster and did the most amazing Hendrix guitar solo you'd ever heard. And he kind of played it with his teeth. And it was like, Dan Hartman was a crazy good guitar player. I mean, these guys were so talented. Pretty great. The three pedals I'm using are the microamp, which is very easy to get. That's my main sound. And then I moved to the Shanks ODS-1 for a little more gain. I have it set just on zero. Of course, you can push it really hard. And then after that, I have an ODR1, Noble's ODR1. So certainly the microamp is easy to get, inexpensive. The Shanks ODS1 is a little too expensive, but worth it, I would say. I back it. You know, John and Vermaram did a lot of hard work getting this thing up to speed. And then, of course, the Noble's ODR1 is the third one. Yes, Dan Hartman, I Can Dream About You from Streets of Fire. Dan Hartman had a big career after the Edgar Winter Group. He was a very talented producer and writer and singer, and he had a very, very big career. Yeah, that Dan Hartman. But he was, I mean, as a band member, he was so great. And Montrose was great, too. Chuck Ruff was great. They were all super great musicians, and Edgar's still great. You know, right before the pandemic, he was here. I got to play rhythm guitar on this Brother Johnny record. This super nice guy, lives over in Beverly Hills with his wife, and now he's on the road with Ringo Starr. So go see Ringo Starr with Edgar Winter and everybody else if you get a chance. Colin Hay, too. Colin Hay's a great guitar player and a great singer, and some really, really other great people, too. So one more solo, then more questions. I love to land on the third of C when it goes there. Case in point. I can do fast triplets on this, but I gotta be really careful not to blow the ending of a fast triplet riff. Oh man, it's so fun. Yeah. Worth a shout out here too. Doug Rappaport plays guitar with Edgar Winter, and he's a great guitar player. He's on the record too, and if you saw Edgar live, you saw Doug, and Doug is just awesome. Okay, that's just the microamp. Now I'm going to add the Shanks ODS1. Barely perceptible boost. I'm actually going to turn the gain up a little bit so it becomes a little more perceptible. So back to the microamp alone. Adding the Shanks. Now I'll add the third one. You do those fast triplets and you just pray that you're gonna land okay. Yeah, so I added the third pedal. It gets pretty creamy. Take away the third pedal, just two. Take away the second pedal, just one. Now let's take away the first pedal, and here's the amp. Just very, very clean. The thing about guitar is guitar players like to play constantly. Like this, they do this run-on sentence. I do it. But the greatest thing is to leave spaces, and that does two things for you. It makes you more musical, more tasteful, the audience likes it better, and also gives your hand a chance to rest. Let me demonstrate that, because I love doing this. The gift of leaving spaces and pauses is that you sound better, and your hand gets a chance to rest in between phrases. Let me show you. So after that last one, my hand was tired, you know. And if you pull strings, I mean, when I pull string, you feel the fatigue set in. So these little breaks are really, really great. And then for rhythm, you know, you can play rhythm pretty constantly because you're not pulling strings. You can lighten up. Like this guitar part, if you notice, just the natural muting I'm doing, I'm lifting my hand off constantly as I choose to actually strike the chords, or strike muted notes, or strike air. So there are natural rests that happen intrinsic to the actual rhythm part. So this is a great subject. Resting your hand is very, very important. Yes, Paul Reed Smith, did he have a heart attack when I told him no birds? I'm glad I wasn't there when he saw this, because I ordered it from Beverly, paid for it, and when he went to sign it, that's probably when he saw that there were no birds, and I think he probably was annoyed and then forgave me, because he forgives me a lot for stuff. So that's a great question, man. You ordered your DGT with moons instead of birds? That's cool. I didn't know you could do that. My. Yeah, I love the birds, but I wanted people to do a little guesswork when they see this guitar and go, what kind of guitar is that? And then realize a couple minutes later that it was a PRS. That was my goal. And it's worked. Gotta play this solo one more time, then let's keep talking. This is fun. I'm literally going, oh gosh, I hope I land on the right note. And I've been lucky so far in the last 20 minutes, so who knows. Any fretting hand pinky exercise to keep it steady. This we get from Phil X, because Phil X is impossible to believe, but he says to me, yeah, my little finger's really weak. And I don't see that when I see him play, but you know what he does? He takes the index finger, and he removes it from the equation, and he just starts practicing with these three fingers. Now give it a try. I'm going to do it right now. Wow. So yeah, just take your index finger out of commission and do everything with these three fingers. And your little finger will, get strong right away, I think. My little finger is a little bit weak also. So I always try and use it. Like, I've even like gone, okay, I'm not going to use my little finger, so I'll start the solo with the little finger just to make sure I use it once. Or, and you know, when I do power chords too, I'm always using the little finger. That's just built in because it doesn't require this big stretch. So all my power chords are with the little finger. So that helps too. So yeah, just consciously bring it in, right? Oh, I got to answer this question. Jurassic Pork Chop asks, have you ever done a session with Tom Bukovac? There is a video on my channel where I feature Tom, and in that video I mentioned that I did a Rob Thomas record about a decade ago here in LA, and they brought Tom out, and we sat side by side, and it was a dream come true for me. You've never seen anybody that good in the studio. I mean, it's the parts and sounds he comes up with are just unbelievable, best ever. G-O-A-T for sure, as far as a studio guitar player. So yes, it was life-changing, it was wonderful. And we became friends after that, we're still friends, Really, he's the fact that he gives us all of that generosity on YouTube these days is great. I watch his channel and I love his honesty, and I root for him, I fight for him. I want him to rule the world. We love Tom. Anyway, guys, thanks so much for this. I'm going to play us out, and we'll see you guys on the next one. It was really, really fun. Out again.